Hey there guys, this is Piper here, and welcome to the next episode of Let's Play Third Age Total War. Now, this is a mod for Medieval 2 Total War, and if you haven't played this before, I'd highly suggest you download this and play some of this mod, because it is rather epic if you enjoy the Lord of the Rings series. So we're actually on turn, or episode number 7, we won the last battle against Isengard. We took over that settlement further down south. We've got a candidate for adoption. He's age 41, he's got one command. Doesn't really have that much else going for him, so we're going to decline this. We can't really afford to keep another general. We're going to move over two troops into that settlement. There is a small band of orcs coming down from the mountains. They have a siege equipment. They have probably two goblin infantry. They are two chefs, so they're actually not bad units. We've got South Tharbad there, and following on from the last episode, we've taken the settlement called Tal Sears. This is quite far into Isengard territory. As you can see, the settlement details is only 3% elves. So I'm probably going to want to build the artist studio, and that will increase the culture by 2%. But we can't really afford it at this present time. So we're probably going to end the turn there. We've got another army of elves being formed further up north. Get these two out here as well. There should be another one over here. It's another Boquendi. Can they make it over yet? And they're going to link up with the army as well. So it's going to cost us a bit of money to get all these troops down. We don't really have that. We've only got 1,100 right now. Don't really have that much money. But again, we want to keep on pressing Isengard. The plan is, if you watched the previous episode, we're going to kick some Isengard ass, link up with Mordor, and then we're going to move on the Misty Mountains. Because part of the High Elves campaign is, well, I'm actually playing the long campaign, eliminate Mordor and Orcs of the Misty Mountains. So you don't have to destroy Isengard. If you check out where the settlements are, you've got Mordor down here, Isengard is right here. So it makes sense for us to take out Isengard as well. But right now we're going to focus on defending that settlement and making another army right here. We lost an army in the forests right here. I think it was at Diplomat Grima. He seems to sort of loiter around my territory. I think he actually turned that army away from me. So we've lost a couple of troops there. Imladris has a lot of troops. We need to have about 4 or 5 units in there in case Goblin Town empties and attacks me. So far it's going not bad actually. Probably there's like 4 units there, and I think I might even, right, I think I'm going to end the turn here. I can't really do much more else till that army comes down from up north. Really want that army to get down ASAP, and then we can start moving further down into Isengard, because we don't want to give Isengard the opportunity to build up more forces and counterattack. So that orc army is actually attacking Austin Edhill. We do actually have 2 fairly good archer units defending that settlement. We've got one that's 20 strong, 3 chefs, one that's 30 strong, 3 chefs. Any more details on the army? It's a goblin infantry and ballista. We're going to move over the 2 units here and attack the orcs of the Misty Mountains. So I want to control this unit myself, or this army myself. Let's keep that tick there and let's fight the battle. So it's not really a major village, this one. We don't really gain that much revenue from the settlement, but we have to control it for the campaign. Again, it's good to have that settlement because it's kind of a stepping stone into the Misty Mountain range. So I'm attacking top down. So my army should probably come in over here somewhere. Which it does, it's over here. It's back here. So we're gonna link up with our reinforcements. Just check what he has actually got. It's probably two goblin infantry and one ballista. So it's actually, he's actually got a unit of war griders. That's kind of unexpected, actually. War griders are actually fairly good units. And he might actually withdraw straight away. So it looks like he's actually withdrawing from the battlefield. He knows he can't win this. Or is he moving for a better position at the top of the hill? So where's the war griders? So it looks like they're actually just going to the top of the hill. So we are going to basically try and get some shots in at the backs of the ballista. Keep it on triple speed. So let's try and get a couple of good volleys in there. And maybe we'll get a couple of good kills. 34. Again, I don't want to sort of run too far forward. The war griders are actually pretty good units. Keep these guys in loose as well, just in case. Keep it on triple speed. And so we did get a couple more kills there. Again, it takes, I think it's about 3 units or 3 men per ballista to actually fire a ballista. So there's about 32 men there, so we've got to kill roughly around about 30 men for that to be out of action. So it might actually be better for us to just kill the goblin infantry and the war griders. So we're going to move forward our archers. We've got our sword Quendi lined up behind the bow Quendi. And hopefully we can get a couple of good shots in there. Okay, that's a lot of damage against the goblin infantry. I think the ballista are firing back. And one thing about Medieval 2 Total War, the artillery is kind of accurate. Going for my general is making the smart move there, going for the general. But again, we're just going to try and get as many kills as we can on the goblin infantry. Again, I don't have the cavalry advantage, so I can't space out my archers because the war griders will rout the archers. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go for the war griders, try and get some kills. The goblin infantry, they're down to 35. If we can get a couple of good volleys in versus the war griders, we can just rush the rest of the units. Looks like he's going to go for the charge. Yeah. So he's going to go for the charge versus the archers, but he can't kill all the archers. Even if he rushes straight forward. So they're down to 20. Go on, shoot the cavalry. And the war griders are down to 12. I'm going to withdraw the archers there. And those archers are actually routing. So the plan here is I'm going to use, hopefully get two more good volleys in versus the war griders. I'm going to pull down the sword Quendi, they're going to attack the goblin infantry and they will actually beat those units. The bow Quendi will come back. I want to switch those guys into flaming arrows. And the goblin infantry, they're going to get attacked from both sides. Get these guys to fire arrows at the warg riders. Get everything to shoot the warg riders, and we're going to get our general to attack the ballista. Because the warg riders, fair enough, it's cavalry, but they can't shoot down, they can't chase down all my archers. So we're going to use our Sword Quendi, they're going to take out the ballista, then that's going to be game over against the enemy army. So let's get our general. General's taking out the ballista. I'll probably chase those guys right off the field, try and get a couple of extra kills if I can. And there's one unit of warg riders left over here somewhere. Straight up over here. Yeah, there they are. They're chasing through the forest. I'm going to pull over the archers over here, get a better shot in, and then hopefully they can take out the warg riders. So these warg riders have done a lot of running, done a lot of fighting. Don't really feel there's going to be enough to defeat all those archers. And that's going to be a victory for our side. So that's the general just died as well. And that's going to be a victory for our side. So we're trying to get the last kill on the warg riders if we can. So we killed the last cavalry right there. And that's going to be a victory for our side. So again, just trying to get the kills when we can. Because it's campaign, fair enough, the battle was won. But all the kills matter in the campaign. You never know when you might need an extra unit of men, or whether taking out two units of snag archers was beneficial. Man of the hour, age 21. Okay, let's accept him. We can put him into that settlement as a general in case anyone else attacks in the future. It's going to cost a bit of money doing that, but I think it's probably worth it, to be honest. There's another unit of Isengard there. We've got Lord Loghur. 5-star general, so he's pretty good. He's got a contingent of 3 units there, so that he could have absolutely anything. Let's check out the levels here. So again, 3%. We're going to build the artist studio. Let's try and increase the culture in the settlement. Again, looks like there might be another. Is that the river there? So there's potentially something over here, possibly a small city. I don't know for definite. And there's going to be probably other settlements as well. Again, I don't know how far Gondor comes up here. But we're doing a good job against Isengard. Need to keep on putting the pressure. Again, this is a couple of settlements that Isengard doesn't have, and that's going to eat into the funds. Plenty of troops there. Possibly retrain some of them. We can't afford it. Right. So again, let's create our army here. That's a fairly large army. These guys deserve it, I'll be fairly angry. So nothing else has really been built. There's another Sword Quendi there, let's move over the Sword Quendi. Right, there's another one there. Let's move that one over as well. And I think I might actually put them into Elastadian. And then we'll just move down that army right now, because that's fairly large. We need those troops down here ASAP to fight against Isengard. We've got a couple of troops in there as well. and plenty of troops right there. I'm going to build the artist studio. So that's going to take two turns to build. Again, we've got a lot of troops in Imladris as well. There's like five troops there. But again, we need those troops to defend Imladris in case the Orcs of the Misty Mountains attack us again. So then we're going to end the turn. We're up to turn number 47. I kind of feel like something's happening up north. I don't really feel like the free peoples of Eriador are doing much down south. So I think maybe they've joined up with the dwarves, and maybe it's the dwarves and the free peoples of Eriador are maybe attacking the Orcs of the Gundabad. Let's check out the settlement right there. So it's still 3%. So hopefully this artist studio is gonna help us a lot with the culture of the settlement. Again, we've got plenty of troops in that settlement there. What can we build? Town Watch, Sculptor's Workshop, or the Vineyard. Again, we're a bit low on funds actually. We don't really have that much money. And that's mainly down to the fact we've got a lot of troops like this army here. And let's pull down this unit. So how many turns will it take? It's going to take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's going to take at least 7 turns before that army becomes effective in the actual fighting zone. So what we might do is we might actually use that army to go down the coast actually and capture some of the settlements down here. If I remember correctly, Rohan is kind of near here. Is that potentially Rohan is right there, maybe? Not too sure, to be honest. But I know that Gondor is here, and Rohan was always the buffer between Gondor and Isengard. We've still got our army there, and they're going to be building the Town Watch. But again, only 2% elves. We've got to keep a fairly large force amongst the settlement. Destroy that. We can't destroy that. So we're going to build the Town Watch. And I think once the Town Watch is built, we're probably going to withdraw that army and start attacking further into Isengard. There's a Isengard force right here. Lord Loghur, Factionaire, 5-star general. What have we got to defend that settlement? We've got two Boquendi and one Swordquendi, one cavalry. So that's 4 versus 4. That should be enough, to be honest. The Swordquendi are the Boquendi are, one is 3 Chev, one is 1 Chev, and the Swordquendi are 2 Chev. We've got the cavalry as well. So that should be enough to defend that settlement. If not, I'll send over some troops from South Tharbad. And I'm going to put some watchtowers up. Okay, this is a bit of a waste of money. I can't really see that far, but it's going to give me the heads up in case anything round about here attacks. And being shadowed by that Servant of Sauron. So that's Yagaz. He's 34 years old. He's fairly obedient. He's basically followed the army from up here all the way down south. And Grima Wormtongue has actually followed me up as well. And he actually turned some of my troops against me as well. See, all the settlements are fairly happy. We've expanded quite a lot in a short space of time. So it's probably okay for us to take our time now. We've got a large army coming down from the north. Hopefully these guys can link up, and there should be some more troops in Lond there. So there's at least another 2 Swordquendi that can be used to bolster that army. So we're going to end the turn here. And obviously there's 2 more troops right there. They're going to link up and form another army. So don't really have that much money at the moment. Again, it surely is the case of having so many trips in the field, it's going to cost a lot of money. But then once the settlements are taken, we can cut back on the armies and then focus on the economy. So we've got a new message here. The chieftain of Isengard is dead. With the death of the late chieftain Isengard, there will be a change in the command of this realm. The lords know not whether to find fear or comfort in this knowledge. So I don't know whether Saruman's dead or whether Saruman comes to power. But we've taken out a good number of factioneers for Isengard. Move this guy down as well. So there's another unit of Isengard right there. We're going to build the watchtower. Get these guys back. So a bit of a waste of money there. I built 3 watchtowers, but I don't really know the area, and obviously I'm trying to play as efficiently as possible. So we kind of know there's going to be a settlement right there. The small Isengard army of Unikai raiders. We're being besieged on the right hand side, and I think I'm going to take out an army and defend that settlement a bit better. So we're going to move over some units. We're going to make it growth build, so they'll be happy. I don't know what it is about growth build, but they seem to love growth build. Costs a bit of money though, but we need to defend, we need to make sure we actually hold the settlement, because this is one of our campaign requirements. We're probably just going to end the turn there. I don't really feel there's much more else we can do. We've got that army coming down. Got the other army being formed up here. There should be another one as well. So that's the Sword Quendi right there. And they're going to form up and link up with that army. So again, it's not really very optimal having so many settlements away, having to build the troops, but these are newly captured settlements. We don't really have enough culture to start building Sword Quendi and Bow Quendi. Again, the further you are away from your kind of homelands, the harder it is to build units. Maybe that's just for the High Elves. And we've got our Isengard army right there. So I think we're just going to end the turn there. I don't really feel there's much more else we can do. Again, we've got all our armies are going down south. We don't really have that much money to build things. Again, that'll all change once we link up with Gondor. But again, this is the first time I've actually played through this campaign. I've played the High Elves bits and bobs ages ago. I've never actually got this far before using the High Elves. And that's that Orc army is just stop sieging Austin Edhill. I think he probably saw my army coming over, but we're going to attack him. It's about 1-to-1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 star general. This man has leadership qualities to enable men to go beyond their own abilities on any battlefield. So we're a bit better than this guy. We're about 1-to-1. A little bit outnumbered. We have far better archers. So we're going to go in for the attack. And hopefully we can do a lot of damage. I've got no doubt we're going to win this battle. But it's just a question of how many men we're going to lose. We want to lose the minimum amount of men, so we have more men to attack Isengard with later. So the plan will be, have we got any Sword Quendi? No Sword Quendi, we've only got archers and cavalry. So I'm going to keep these guys in tight formation. Don't know exactly what he has. He's got Clansmen. He's got, that looks like it's Dunlendy Bodyguards. And he's got one Uruk-hai Infantry. So is he running away or is he just retreating to a better position? So again, one of the benefits for him being in the forest, cavalry isn't as effective fighting in wood areas. So it looks like he's just withdrawing to a better position. We're going to advance our archers. And again, don't really see any archers on his side. He's got some snaga skirmishers. He's got bodyguard axemen, looks like. Or are they just regular sort of woodsmen, possibly? And the clansmen. The key here is take out the general. The general is the best unit as well. I don't know whether these guys are orc bodyguards or just Uruk-hai infantry, but they'll be pretty good on the stats. Move these guys forward, move the cavalry forward. Let's get these guys to run over. Just start shooting away at the enemy archer, at the enemy infantry. Okay, let's go for the clansmen. Pull these guys back. I'm just going to withdraw everything. We're going to charge in, actually. I'm just going to charge in the cavalry to take out the snag of skirmishers. We actually charge forward his veterans. So they're not Dunlending bodyguards, they're just the veterans. They are actually pretty good, but they're not amazing. So we're going to now shoot the veterans. This causes a wooded area. Maybe he gets a bit more coverage, but he's taking a lot of damage right there. He's getting caught in a crossfire. See all the troops there. He's getting shot from all sides. Again, provided these guys are on skirmish, there's going to be no threat at all. Just got to make sure they don't get chased off the map. So what to do now is stop the guys. I told them to fire at the veterans. So we're going to give them the ability to choose their own targets. So they are actually Uruk-hai bodyguards. So they're actually better than I actually thought. I don't want them to engage. It's like pull back, pull back. So there's the cavalry right there. Okay, getting a bit close to my cavalry. So we're going to go for a quick charge against the snag of skirmishers. And that's one more unit taken out. So the skirmishers are actually on the verge of routing. It says loading, wavering. But the clansmen are coming in there for a charge versus my cavalry. So we're going to have to pull those guys out before the clansmen get involved. So I'm going to have to see what's happening. Because it's a lot of wood in this area, it's kind of hard to see what's actually happening. So I might actually pull over. I was going to hammer an anvil at Uruk-hai bodyguards. That's probably a stupid move to make. bodyguards, clansmen. So they actually turn around there. So they're going to get some good shots in the Boquende against those units of veterans. Some more clansmen right there. So we're actually winning the battle. It looks like the enemy's actually changed direction and they're actually going for... They wanted to regroup with the general. So I might do this, I might actually go for a quick charge in, using the hill advantage, charge out, get some shots on the side. The other two units of archers are doing a good job, they haven't really suffered too many damage. We've only got 16 Nor Eternal Warriors. And that spearman coming down. Do a quick charge here. So we killed the enemy general, that was actually quite a good move there. We're going to pull out our general. And I think we might actually switch to flame and arrows possibly. For a second I thought it was actually my general that died. We need to somewhat regroup. So are they shooting the backs? So they're shooting the backs of... I think they're shooting the backs of... There's actually units over here. According to the minimap. So they're shooting the backs of a snag of skirmishers. But again... Just need to keep on putting the pressure. Where's the cavalry? And again, using the Nor Eternal Warriors, and hopefully get some shots in the back of the Yokai bodyguards. So this is a good unit to actually take off the field. Yokai bodyguards are really powerful. Move these guys over. Can you get these guys to shoot the veterans? Triple speed. I'm gonna pause it. So they're down to 26. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna link up with my other army. I'm gonna pull these guys over with the general. Actually, something coming up here, according to the map. Is that just the Snaga? Oh, that's just the Snaga skirmishers. So they're actually routing. So got a funny feeling the enemy's actually withdrawing now. So there's some there. So we've got more archers here. So the veterans have actually turned direction. They were getting chased down and now they're going to get shot in the backs. And we're going to triple speed it again. And again, the clansmen are coming up here. We're going to switch to flaming arrows now. It's time to shoot some, if we can, that is. And they're coming. They're actually wavering. So these guys are doing a lot of running. They've lost their general, but they're actually spearmen. So my general is actually gold on the chevron. So it's gone gold. It's gone bronze chev, silver chev. Now it's gold chev. So I'm waiting for these guys to actually rout. And then we will probably end the battle. So it's definitely going to be a victory for us. We haven't lost too many men. We get caught at the start with from the No Eternal Warriors against the Yurikai bodyguards. But we don't want to be complacent, don't want to lose the general. So if we can find out where he is, he's actually right there. So it looks like he's actually withdrawing off the field now. So we're going to move forward all of our archers to this position. And then we can get some good shots in. Keep them on skirmish at will, obviously. It says here they're waving, so I'm going to do a rear charge. See if I can rout them off the field. So I don't want to pause it. So it says here they're broken. We're going to get the rest of our archers to shoot the... So they're 19. And that's the general over here, isn't it? So get these guys to shoot the bodyguards. These guys will mop up the veterans. And I'm going to hammer an anvil the Yurikai warriors. Got the cavalry coming down. And that's going to be a victory for us. So we're going to take off fire at will, just in case we shoot our own men. Get these guys to attack now. We'll triple speed. And that'll be the battle over. So that's another Isengard force taken out of the battle zone. So again, you want to keep on, you don't want to fight too many major battles. Again, the bigger the battle, the more chance the enemy has against you. If you defeat the enemy in small skirmishes, you have got much better chance of completing the campaign faster and not losing too many men. So that's going to be the game over. Well, that's a heroic victory for our side there. Only lost 20 men, killed about 200 enemy men. So that's some good stats there. And that's going to help the settlement that was under siege on the previous turn. So again, you can only afford to keep so many men in the settlements. 615. I'm going to ransom. It's quite a lot of money, actually. I would have probably executed. But that's quite a lot of money. I only had 300 in the bank at that point. Agent detected, Isengard. So where is this? Gonna pull this guy back. And we can't recruit anything. We've got up to 6% now for the culture. Could build the grain exchange. But I think we're going to hold on to that settlement. We're going to keep a large force here. We've got another army coming down here. It's going to take a couple of turns for them to get down. And there's not really much more we can do with that army. We want to keep a couple of units in Austin Ed Hill. What can we build in Rivendell? Not too much, actually. Build the vineyard. I wonder if we can maybe increase the tax rate. Would that be an option? Okay, let's put it to normal for the tax rate in Horwell. Tharabad. Anything except growth build, they don't like. So, I'm going to go up north. Can we increase it to very high? Because we need funds. We don't have any money at the moment. They don't like that. Leave that. High tax rate. So we're going to make a couple of these settlements high tax rate or higher tax rate. Because we don't really have any money at all. I can afford to have a couple of people angry for a while. And then we'll put it back to normal tax rate. But we need money for this war against Isengard. And here we go, here's a large battle. So Isengard's brought forward an army undetected. Fairly large army actually, Yuriki Raiders, Guards of the Orthanc, he's got 10 of those guys. And they're elite. Can do shield trim, extra morale, good stamina. So it looks like these guys are actually the wild men, but they're heavily armoured in Yuriki armour. They're really good. Don't know if I've got enough to defeat all that. I've only got 5 troops. Okay, I'm going to withdraw from the battle. I don't like having to withdraw, but I'm going to have to, and same again's happened here. So I'm going to have to fight this one. We've got a 3-5 ratio. We've got a chance at winning this, we've got enough archers. But again, I can't withdraw, I'm going to have to fight it. If we can maximise the archers and use the cavalry, we should have a chance. I don't think the enemy has any cavalry, but it's going to be pretty difficult. Because we don't have, our archers aren't full strength. So we're going to deploy over here. Put some over here as well. Start a battle. Just check out the army. He's got ballista. He doesn't have any cave trolls, that's one thing. He's got those guards of the Orthanc, or warriors of Orthanc. They're really good stats. Again, probably best going for the general, I'd imagine. Kill the general and then try and hammer an anvil. Try and get some fast routes, because we don't have enough men to defeat this army. Don't think he's got any archers though. We're a bit close to the red line. I think we're gonna pull everything up here, I think. Well, that's gonna eat into our energy. Well, I think we're gonna stay here for a bit, see what happens. Look, I can't really withdraw too far because we're quite close to the red line. But we'll keep it on triple speed. So that's the guards of the Orthanc. So we're going to go for the kills against snag skirmishers with the archers. We're going to use the other archers to target the Yuriki Raiders. And he's left his skirmishers vulnerable. So he's got archers as well. Damn. Didn't see the archers. They were kind of blended into the background. So we're going to pull out the cavalry and go for some kills against the snag archers. Probably going to lose this battle, to be honest. I don't really feel as much hope of winning. But if we can push back the archers. Maybe separate some of the units. Get some better kills. And we're going to try and get some kills on the enemy snag archers. So that's the snag archers right there. We're going to have to pull them out because the Yuriki bodyguards are coming down. Move those guys over there. Go for another round of kills against the Snaga Skirmishers. I think we're going to go for the kills against the Ballistas, to be honest. And we've got the enemy separated, this is what we want to happen. need to remember those guys are off fire at will, and we're going to charge the ballista. So the ballista are down to 6. If we can get them down to 2, they'll stop firing ammunition or stop firing arrows. They're down to 2 now. Take these guys away now. That's good for us, and we can pull these guys back down to start firing in versus. So where's the archers? We're going to go for the archers first. So put them back onto fire at will. I've still got 8 archers. He's actually targeting my cavalry right there. Something shot at my cavalry. And hopefully we can route the snag archers. But it's not looking too good, to be honest. He seems to be chasing my cavalry a lot. If we can just kill the snag archers. And they're down to 9. We're gonna have to withdraw these guys though. The Yurikai raiders are coming in fairly strong. Pull these guys out now. We've got a unit of archers, Boquendi. Those guys are over here. And let's try and get the kills on the skirmishers now. So we've got a chance at winning this now. We've taken out the ballista. They've got loads of space to move there. We're going to go for the snag skirmishers. Going to get everything in guard mode in case they get caught by the enemy infantry. We'll take out the snag skirmishers. They're going to have to rout from this. There's no way they're going to stand from this cavalry charge. They're down to what, 9 and 27. Unfortunately, we actually lost 2 cavalry right there. But they're getting a lot of kills on the snag of skirmishers. And what's happened? They haven't lost too many men. The snag of skirmishers down at 23. Still got more archers over here. And this is where it becomes good for us. They've actually turned their backs on those archers. And we're going to get these guys out of skirmish mode, get them over here. That's in their Eternal Warriors. Got to pull back the cavalry now. The clansmen are coming in, if we can get these guys out. So got our cavalry out there. And we're going to try and withdraw them to the hill. Get plenty of time, so we've got it back a bit more now. We're about, probably about 4-3 possibly. And they're going to avoid the Yurikai raiders right there. Get our Eternal Warriors over here as well. Take some Siren shots possibly. And so where's our... So that's the guards of the Orthanc. Quite far away actually, but they're going to get caught if we don't do something about it. Don't think that's deliberate. So we're going to move these guys up to here. Cavalry. And now we can start focusing on getting some decent kills on the enemy. So where are these guys? Losing track of where people are. So losing a couple of men here. They got shot. So he's over here. This guy's back. And so I'm going to have to watch these guys. These guys have run through the enemy. They're not wavering. They're high elf bowmen, so they have good morale. So just need to hold these guys at bay, charge these guys forward. And hopefully we can get some good kills on these units now. So they are the Yurukai Raiders, and Dunlending Clansmen. So I'm going to try and take out Snaga Archers once and for all. Still got the cavalry. The cavalry are tired. They're going to charge up here. And use the cavalry to go for the Snaga Archers. So they lost a couple of men there. That's from Snaga Archers. Shit. Wrong one. They don't have Skirmish one. Forgot about that. Move these guys forward now. We need to get some more kills on the Dunlending Clansmen. Yurukai Raiders suffer a lot of damage. They're not easy to take out though, the Raiders. They're not as easy as the Snaga Skirmishers. So I don't really want to use my cavalry. I could do a hammer and anvil with the infantry. I might do that. I'm going to charge in the Bokwendi. Go for the rear charge. So this guy's actually pretty good. He gets a lot of hit points against orcs. So they're gonna rout pretty soon from that. And hopefully they rout before the clansmen come in. Don't think they are though. So I'm gonna pull them out. So they actually routed before the clansmen come in. So we've got more opportunities now to defeat the clansmen. So the battle's actually starting to turn in our favour. There's still a lot of enemy, we've got a lot of Yurukai Raiders there. I'm going to pull these guys up. I'm going to go for another charge in versus the Snaga Skirmishers. Come on, move back. I think he's semi-glitched there. So I'm gonna use the cavalry against the Snaga Skirmishers once and for all. Again, there's that unit of the guards of the Orthanc. Hit 1, 2, 3, 4. So try to keep track of all my units. So if we win this battle, this is going to be a major victory for us. Again, it's still kind of against us, to be honest. Right, so they never had skirmish mode on. Don't really feel like I can hammer an anvil effectively. Yeah, let's do it here. I'm going to attack from all sides, try and get the fast route. So hopefully this combined charge from the Boquendi and the cavalry will rout the Dunlending clansmen fast. Then we can concentrate on taking out the rest of the orc army. So they're routing right there. Let's get our cavalry out of danger. So there's still 24 Dunlending clansmen, that's still quite a lot. I'm gonna pull those guys over there. And pull those guys over here. Because I don't want them to run to the red line and get caught. So I think we're gonna switch to Flaming Arrows. Try and get the kills on the Yukai Raiders. And is that the general? I think that's the general right there. We're going to do the same again. We're going to charge from all sides and use the cavalry. And they're actually broken now. So the battle's turned in our favour, but we don't want to sort of lose our general. So we're going to try and shoot the enemy general, try and get the kill. Though he's got caught there, let's pull him back. And that's the general right there. Though I think the enemy army is actually just withdrawing right now. I don't really feel they're actually going for my army. These guys keep getting caught by the enemy. They need to pull back, they're very tired. Okay, let's take fire off. I don't think the guards of the Orthanc would rout enemy. Okay, let's go for this unit of Yukai Raiders. Let's try and pull these back as best as we can. Let's just pull them back over here. Try and get the kills from all sides. The guards of the Orthanc are quite far away, so we have the opportunity to get the kill and the rout on the Yukai Raiders. I think we're going to pull these guys back. Those guys are going to right off the field. Keep these guys firing right in there at the sides. Might as well use the advantage of the archers. And they are getting kills. Let's try and get the kill on the general. And where's my... No Eternal Bodyguards, they're over here. Or No Eternal Warriors, they're over here. So those Naga Skirmishers are still alive. Pull them over here. Let's pull our general back before he dies from the guards of the Orthanc. So I think we're just going to probably hammer an anvil now. We're going to go in for the charge if we can get the fast route. They'll route away from this area. Defeat is a distinct possibility. Victory seems certain. Shit. Oh, they're routing actually. Let's move over the archers over here. So we really want to kill on the enemy general because he is actually a, I think he's a 3-star general. Okay, let's try and help these guys out. They've been chased over the whole map. Let's try and get some kills on these Uruk-hai bodyguards. So they're still 22 in number. They're 21 now. Again, I could triple speed this, but again, it's not a definite victory for our side yet. We do have the archer advantage, but the victory isn't set in stone just yet. I'm gonna make sure these guys are right off the field. Try and get some more kills with the archers. Get some good kills right there. Switch them to flaming arrows. Let's see if we can route that unit. Take these guys out of the equation. So is that the general? So that's the general right there. So we want the general to die. We're going to shoot the remaining arrows at Yokai bodyguards. Or is that the general? I don't know where the general is. But we're going to take out that unit there. And they're wavering. Switch to flaming arrows. And let's continue this. So let's take off fire at will, just in case any friendly fire kills. And let's triple speed. So that's quite a good victory for us. Again, we had to do quite a lot of micro in there. Use our archers fairly well, and it was quite a much more powerful army than ours. But again, it's just a case of using the archers well, making sure you're making the most out of your army. So that's going to defend South Tharbad against Isengard. Again, they're still putting a lot of pressure on my southern flank. Not too much left for the enemy army in this. I think there's some snag archers that are there. Send the cavalry up. But the cavalry's already maxed to 3 gold chevrons. So you don't get any more than gold chevrons in Rome Total War or Medieval Total War. They're going to go up and get the 2 kills on the snag of skirmishers, and that's going to be GG for us, as they say. So that was a really good victory. That was a heroic victory for our side. Again, a lot more kills than the enemy. Didn't really lose that many men. Lost 39 men. Killed 344 enemies. Again, it had to be done because we had to really save South Tharbad. If we hadn't won that battle, no doubt that army would have sieged South Tharbad. And we would have probably lost that because we don't really have that much. So we've got a ransom here for 6,000. I don't have any money at all. I'm going to ransom. Or do I want to ransom? Yeah, let's ransom. So ransom rejected anyway, so they had to be executed. Which is fine, because either way, we can't really afford to have too many men in this area. So we're going to move over that unit there. They're going to join up with that army. And that's going to be another army to come down. This is the other large army coming down. And I think we're going to go down here. I'm pretty sure there's going to be a settlement in here. We've got 2 Isengard armies right here. And obviously we've won that battle with minimal resources. And there's another orc army right there. So we're probably going to have to put some more men into Austin Edhill. Okay, let's put 2 units of Boquendi into Austin Edhill. Put the rest of these guys back into South Tharbad. Again, nothing is actually sieging Imladris. What can we build? Can we build anything? Can't really build too much. We don't really have that much money. As I said before, we're waiting for this army to come down. And they're going to take that settlement. And then that's going to be another area that's going to be clear from Isengard. So I've got no doubt there's going to be more Isengard down here. But we're getting closer to Gondor. We're allied with Gondor. And once that happens, Gondor can fight Mordor. I will take out Misty Mountains. I'll have to go into the caves and fight the Balrogs. And then we'll take on Mordor at the end. So again, not much more we can actually do. Can we build anything else? Stables. Build stables, I guess. Let's cycle through what we can build. Vineyard. Don't really see the point building vineyard. Let's build the town watch. Can we retrain? Nope. So let's end the turn there. And that's going to move on to the next phase. So hopefully Isengard won't attack us again. Again, they've done a lot of attacks against South Tharabad. I know that they actually go for Aragorn quite a lot if you don't have South Tharabad. But I haven't really encountered the orcs of the Grundabad. So I haven't really had to defend my northern areas, my northern provinces. But here we have a bride presented, bethroned, Thalion, Morniel. So let's accept this. It means that they can get married, potentially have some kids, and that will be generals of the future. So there's the Isengard army. But I'm probably going to hold my army in that settlement. Again, just check out the details. It's now 10% on the elves. Vineyard, grain exchange. And keep on with trying to increase culture. We've got our army coming down here. It'd be like 1, 2, 3 turns. And I've got 2 more Sword Quendi in this area. I can join them with that army and then we'll move further down south. And I reckon probably the coastal areas, they'll be quite lucrative with the fishing ports. And I'm going to put those 2 Bo Quendi into Austin Edhill. Again, I can't really build too much. I don't have the funds. If that orc army moves to attack Horwell, we're going to have to take troops out of Imladris and defend. Because we don't have enough. Don't really see too much of the Free Peoples of Eriador. They've got some troops here. I don't know what they're doing up north. I might actually... I've got my diplomat who is right here. They're keeping tabs on Goblin Town. So shit, they've actually created cave trolls now. So we'll just check out some of the stats in the cave trolls. We can't see the stats, but we can check out the abilities. Frighten nearby enemy, exit morale, recharge without orders, powerful charge, can't hide good stamina, fast moving. So these guys are pretty powerful. Takes a lot to pull these guys down. And that changes the actual battle now, because I can't just go in there and attack that settlement. I've got to take some pretty good troops with me. So that's our army there. They're going to form up. And we're going to move these guys down as well. So let's move these guys down to Lord Deer. What we might do is we might actually move that first army down. We've got 3 units coming down. They'll make a smaller army of 5. Maybe just reinforce a settlement down here, or join up with Tal Seer and move to the right. Because I do know the main Isengard city is actually right there. So we don't actually have too much uncovered in this area. I might build a watchtower right here, just to see what's happening. And let's move that guy back before the settlement gets too angry. So we'll switch it to growth build till the general gets back, and we're going to end the turn. So again, like I've been saying before in the previous turns, again, I'm spending a lot of money on the army. So even though I do have an economy base, I'm not really been able to get that much money. I've had to really sort of try and scrimp some money together on the left-hand northern provinces. These guys are paying very high tax rates. Can't really afford to get too much more tax. They might actually turn against me. So that army there, they're actually, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Boquendi and 4 Swordquendi. So I'm fairly certain there's going to be a settlement down here. It's just a question of how big the settlement will be. So there's a pathway there as well. So I reckon if we can capture that settlement, we're going to hold a pretty strong border here. I don't really feel there's going to be too much over here either. There's going to be a couple of Gondor settlements. I can't remember if that's Osiliath or if that's Minas Tirith, but it's a major Gondor settlement. And if we can link up with Gondor and link up with Rohan, we can consolidate our borders and then take on Mordor. So that's going to be the plan. Again, we don't really have much fundage. I'm going to see South Arbad, what we can build. Can we change that to normal tax rate? High tax rate? Yeah, high tax rate it is. So we're actually gaining an extra 50 per turn, changing South Arbad to high tax rate. Ossenild, change it to high tax rate as well. Imladris is already a very high tax rate. And Horwell, what's the population? Is it 30% elves? Can't really change the tax rate too much, to be honest. Change it to high tax rate. And at least that'll give us like a turn where we get some extra money back. If I've got to change it back to low tax rate to avoid rebellion, I'll do that. But the coffins are fairly low on the money. So that's the turn cycling through there. I know there's going to be a lot of action on the right-hand side. The Sylvan Elves are probably deep in it against Rune and Harad. I know Gondor is going to be attacked by everyone at the start. But we're going to move that army down. We're going to capture that settlement. I don't really see much else happen. There's probably another large... Well, there's an army there from Isengard. That's the main settlement right there. So we're going to have to probably put some more troops into South Arbad. There's that orc army right there. It's a unit of heavy goblin halberd. So they're just... They have really big spears, these guys. Don't really have the best defense against arrows or melee combat, but they're really an offensive unit. What can we build here? Mustering Hall stables. So let's build the mustering hall. So this Argon settlement is actually fairly southern in the central position. So if I can start producing troops in Argon, it's going to be really beneficial. Again, can't really build anything else because we don't really have the money. Okay, we're going to build another watchtower right there. So it looks like we've actually met up with Rohan. I can see a different border right here. Yeah, that's not your typical Isengard border. Yeah, that's going to be Rohan. So hopefully we can get this army down here, attack that settlement, get this general back into the settlement, or the city rather. We can consolidate our forces and then we're going to take out Isengard once and for all. Because these orcs are really pissing me off. There's always orcs up there and that's really affecting my trade. And also there's some sort of orc settlement amongst this area that keeps them producing orcs. So it's not really a major threat. We'll deal with it after we take out Isengard. But right now the most important thing we can do is keep on pressing down south. So we're going to end the turn here. We've only got 200 gold coins. Again, like before, we can't do much more else. So we're going to end the turn there. We're going to get that general back into that settlement and then move the army down south to capture what looks to be the final settlement of Isengard in the east. Candidate for adoption. Again, we can't really afford it. We're going to have to decline that offer. Rioting in Tal Seer. That's okay. We've got our general coming back. Isengard, we're trying to move over there against us. Get these guys out of operation and get them back into the building. Or back into the settlement. So, the settlement is either going to be over here or over here. I reckon it's probably down here somewhere. That's it right there. And there's a couple of troops in here. There's a general, Yasmus. He's a 5-star general, 48 years old, fairly loyal, and 4 obedient. Traits unknown. Got some Snaga skirmishes right there, so that's going to be our next target. We're going to take out that settlement. And I think that's actually the border with Rohan. So once we capture that settlement, we can just basically move along. Take out Isengard, and that's going to be a united front against Mordor and the Orcs of the Misty Mountains. There's an Isengard army there, but they're only 4 strong. And there's another one, right, here as well. So I don't really feel they're that strong. There's 3 units there. Okay, they're going to move down here. We're gonna keep two units right in there, and then we're gonna combine two with 3 there. I don't like the fact that there's an Isengard army kicking about. So we're gonna end the turn, siege the next settlement, capture it hopefully, and kick Isengard out of the eastern central area of the map. And that's really gonna help Rohan. So they're gonna attack Argond. So Argon's kind of a favourite target for Isengard. So even if we lose Argon, we're going to do as much damage as we can. New mission. It is time to further our great empire by extending our borders. The council suggests you take the settlement for the glory of the nation. Well, we're going to take it anyway. That's the plan. And it looks like it's a village anyway, so we're going to assault. And like always, we're going to fight the battle. We don't want to rely on the CPU to fight our battles for us, because more often than not, the CPU lets us down. Start deployment. Get our archers here. Don't really think there's too many enemy archers, so the best place is going to be over here. Get our Sword Quendi lined up. Let's get the battle started. So it's just going to be a shitload of Snaga skirmishers. It's going to be pretty easy to win this, to be honest. Actually, that might actually be the better place, because there's the big tower right there defending the enemy. So let's move these guys over. Let's move over the Sword Quendi and start getting some shots in. So they've got a Uruk-hai bodyguard, so they've got a lot of Snaga skirmishers. It's probably like about 3-2, but that's provided the Snaga skirmishers get shots in, which they won't. And they're going to open up against the Snaga skirmishers. So no doubt they'll probably run it to try and attack us. And we'll probably keep these guys in fire at will. Any target here is going to be good. Well, they're 29, 25... 18, 17. So we're going to pull back the Sword Quendi. Don't want to engage in hand-to-hand combat just yet. want to make use of the archers first. They're down to 7, so once this guy dies, it's effectively game over. They're not going to have a hope in hell to win against the Sword Quendi. And the only thing, these bloody generals take ages, tons of arrows. It's like a machine gun of arrows firing against them. So that's the general dead. Got a major advantage. Enemy general has fallen. Yasma's Isengard. So the rest of the archers are going to fire in versus the snag archer, the snag of skirmishers. Hopefully get as many kills as we can. Okay, and all these guys are just jam-packed together. Keep it on triple speed. Again, it's just all these arrows that are falling, they're all hitting targets. It's going to be probably game over pretty soon. I don't really feel they're going to put up much opposition. And we've got 4 full strength Sword Quendi and 5 virtually full strength Bo Quendi, or they are pretty much full strength Bo Quendi. All these arrows are hitting. They've got about half their arrows left. We're just going to keep this on triple speed. Again, nothing much more we can do. Just fire off these arrows, try and get all the kills. Let's go for some shots in versus the Snag of Skirmishers, the unit that's 32. And pull these guys back. So they're into 6. So there's still a lot of archers left that have arrows. These guys are getting a lot of good shots in there. Just the nature of the buildings, so they're having to fire over the buildings. They're not getting the best of shots in, but they are doing a lot of damage. Let's pull these guys back because they've used up their arrows. And let's fire off these arrows versus the Snag of Skirmishers. So I think what we might do is we might actually just switch these guys to flaming arrows and then charge in everything. And that's the Sword Quendi going in. So I'll take these guys off fire at will once the Sword Quendi get in contact. So they're going to get him to stop firing. That's going to be game over. Again, Sword Quendi versus Snag of Skirmishers. They'll get absolutely destroyed. And that's going to be a victory for our side. And that's going to be a victory for the Elven side. So we've won the battle there. We've captured the settlement. Yeah, that's Isengard no longer has any influence in the east now. We've teamed up with the Rohan border. If you look at the border right there, that's Rohan. And again, exterminate populace. You want to destroy that building. We want to build our own town watch. So we'll build that on the next turn, if we can. We'll build it on this turn actually. And then we've got a bit of a problem here with Taos here. For some reason it's on very high tax rate. Don't know why that is. Change it to normal tax rate. And we need to repair the artist studio. Can't recruit anything. Build 10 watch. There's another Isengard army right there. We're being besieged at Argond as well. So we are going to move over to Sword Quendi up here. We've got three coming down over here. They're going to take 3 turns to get here though. 2 turns to get there. They'll take 1 turn. Argond probably has enough to defend. I've got 1 Lindenlong Spear, 2 archers and 1 Sword Quendi. what have they got? They've only got three, so there's probably enough there to defend that settlement, but we don't want to sort of take any chances and let Isengard back and have a foothold in the sector. So we're going to end the turn there, I think. And if they attack on the next turn, I'm going to have to defend. So it looks like they're going to attack here. Just depends what they have. If they have a lot of, if they have any Uruk-hai, probably going to lose. But then the Linden long spears are actually pretty good. So we've got to capture another settlement. That's right there. So that's why Isengard is attacking so much. Again, move these guys up here. Move these guys over. And they are happy. So we're going to go for the growth build. We're going to build the Town Watch. We've only got 5% culture. So I'm not going to take everyone out just yet. I'm going to keep that army in there for maybe a couple of turns. Just till we get some more elves living in the settlement. And then we'll withdraw our forces here. And we'll combine with another army up here. Probably this army here, I'd imagine. Let's build a watchtower. And let's get these guys back into the city. Growth build. So we took a bit of risk there, but you tend to find cavalry travel faster than infantry. So it gives us like a bit of an edge, like to see what's actually happening. Might do the same here actually. I've got... I can't do anything, so... Gotta get that guy back into the settlement. Growth build again. They actually love growth build. Any problems with any settlement, anyone has any problems like rioting or issues, put them to growth build, and usually 9 times out of 10 sorts out most problems. So we're going to end the turn there. Hopefully taking out Isengard in this area is going to help Rohan. And they're going to attack Argond right there. So they can probably see more troops coming over. They probably think, well, we don't have a chance at winning this. So we're going to have to withdraw this guy. Withdraw from battle. Shit. So that was probably a mistake to keep that guy over there. I shouldn't have done that, but again, don't really have much option. We're going to automatically resolve the battle, clear defeat. And he actually dies in that, so... That was a bit of a bummer, to be honest. But hey, we're going to save 500 per turn, so it's not too bad, I guess. We don't actually need that general anyway. Would have been good to sort of have some more watchtowers in this area. But it was costing us money. Let's retrain him. Okay, we're going to build a leather tanner in this area because we're going to have to build more troops. And looks like he's still attacking that settlement. So we're going to push back the Isengard army. So what's he actually got? He's got two Dunlending veterans, one Snaga archer, and he's got a shitload of siege equipment against our forces. So I reckon we can win this. We've got enough arrows. Fight on battle map. So provided we keep our forces together, keep our archers separated, we should have a good shot winning this. Again, you tend to find on very hard. You don't want to sit back too much and defend and wait for the enemy to sort of come out to attack. You want to be very aggressive. You want to keep on attacking the enemy, take the settlements, and not waste too much time, because time is money. So it looks like he wants to come down to attack. Pull these guys down here. One. These guys two. Yeah, so you want to make sure you're grouping your units there. It just makes it a lot easier to control and manage your forces. Gonna move these guys up here before the snag archers get into range. So the snag archers are going to be within range, but our elven archers are going to start shooting the Dunlending veterans. Get some good siren shots there. And our other forces are coming down here. So this is perfect. We're going to get some really good shots in the backs there against the veterans. And we're just going to try and shoot the enemy units, the enemy infantry. We're going to leave the archers because the more we can easily defeat the archers with our sword Quendi. We're going to go for archers here actually. Okay, what we've got here is two. So these guys are over here. Let's bring these guys over. So we're gonna try and get some shots in versus the Dunlending veterans. I don't know if we have enough to actually win this. I don't know how strong these guys are. Three Chev. I'm not even going to bother putting these guys into loose formation. Okay, let's try and get some more shots in against the snag archers. I think that's probably the better option here. Let's reduce the... They're actually 47, so they're going to hold some... Again, he's trying to rush my Linden Long Spears. I'm going to switch targets and shoot the backs of the veterans, try and get some shots there. They're down to 55. It looks like he's going to rush my other army here as well. So getting a lot of good kills against the veterans right there. They're down to 54. They were about, I think, 70 or 60 before. Can't remember the exact number. Okay, we're going to use this advantage opportunity and take out the archers. Shit. So they actually rushed my sword Quendi there. Quite a good move. So we're going to pull back our archers, our infantry. We're going to try and chase down the enemy snag archers. So we're going to have to do some pretty good work here. We've actually routed the snag archers. We're going to pull over the our archers and attack. Okay, screw it. Let's just attack the veterans. We can attack from both sides. Attack one from up a top of the hill, and we'll attack from below as well. And we should win this. So defeat seems certain. So that's the major one right there. That's the three shevd Dunlending veterans. They're getting attacked from both sides. And if we can win over here as well, it'll be really helpful. So these veterans are down to 1817. Their general has just died. They're going to rout from that broken fighting to the death. Going to move over these units and start helping our own men. So that's the other unit of Dunlending veterans. They're down to 15. We're going to continue the battle. Try and get the kills. They're actually a fairly good unit, that one. Three chevrons. And we'll keep it on triple speed. That's going to be a victory for our side. Again, that's going to be the settlement safe, Argond. They were under siege. I've got five or three more units coming down from the north. They are going to probably reinforce that settlement actually. That's the Snaga archers. They're probably too far to get caught up, but we're going to chase them off the field anyway. And that's going to be the end of that battle. So that was a clear victory there. We lost a couple of men there, but when you consider the quality of the enemy troops, not really too surprising we lost about 65 men. And we're going to execute the prisoners, because we can't really afford to have too many men in this area. And we'll accept this guy as captain. Put him into Argond. And put these guys into Argond as well. So that's the battle won. We've taken over that settlement. Got the a noble death. What happened? Thalion died. Oh, he died in battle. So he actually died over here. I could actually put him into that settlement there. And there's another Isengard army coming down. But anyway, Argond is safe. I think I'm going to end the episode here. We've achieved quite a lot. We've pushed Isengard very far back now. Captured two important settlements. And we've recaptured South Tharbad. So again, like always, thank you for watching this episode of Let's Play the Third Age High Elves campaign. Again, it's a brilliant mod. Please download it. You'll have a great time. If you haven't already, like, comment and subscribe. Stay tuned for the next video or the next part of this Let's Play campaign. Thanks for watching. This is Piper signing off.